Hi folks, myself Dr. S. Saravana Sundaram, Professor and Head Department of Biomedical Engineering, Hindustan College of Engineering and Technology. Today we are going to discuss about the topic Design of Synchronous Sequential Circuit from the subject Digital Electronics. Let me move on to the subject. Sequential circuit is a combination of combination logic circuit and memory element. Normally, flip-flop is used as memory element. In synchronous sequential circuit, output not only depends upon present input and also previous input which is stored in the memory element. Before discussing about synchronous circuit design, we have to discuss about procedure of designing synchronous sequential circuit. First procedure, state diagram. State diagram nothing but pictorial representation of state table. So in state diagram, present state is represented by circle and arrow starts and ends at same circle represents present state and next state is same and arrow represents next state of current present state. Then two numbers are indicated in every arrow, first number input, second number output. Now I am going to demonstrate a sample state diagram. Here four present states are there: 00, 01, 10, 11. If you consider 00, when first number is 0, nothing but input, arrow starts and ends at same circle, that indicates present state and next state is same. When first number 1, the 00 state goes to 01. That means when input 1 is applied, the next state of 00 is 01. Then second number indicates output. So when input 0 is applied, output 0. When input 1 is applied, output 0. If you consider 01 state, when applying 0 input, first number, arrow goes to 11. So that means when applying 0 input to the 01 state, next state is 11. When applying 1 input, arrow starts and ends at same circle. So when applying input 1 to the 01 state, next state is 01. Then output when 0, 0, when 1, 0. Similarly, you can analyze remaining present states 1, 0 and 1, 1. After analyzing, we can develop state table. Here I have developed state table. For example, first case 0, 0, input denoted by I, 0. Then next state 00, because in the state diagram present state 00, when input 0 is applied, arrow starts and ends at same circle, so next state is same as like present state, so we have indicated 00, then corresponding output 0, second number. Then second row, now consider second row 00, same present state, but now input 1, when input 1 is applied, the arrow goes to 01 in previous state diagram. So next state 01, then output 0. Similarly, 01 state, when input 0 is applied, next state 00. Then 01, same state, but now input 1, next state 10. So very, very important information. I have developed state table from the state diagram. So similarly, you can develop state table. Developing state table, then as an engineer we have to analyze state reduction. State reduction means the process of eliminating the equivalent or redundant state from a state table. It is called state reduction. What is mean by redundant state? When after developing state table, when two states are having same next state and same output, then these two states can be called as redundant state. That explanation I have given here. Two states are said to be redundant or equivalent if every possible set of inputs generate exactly same output and same next state. So it is called redundant state. If you find any redundant state in state table, one state can be eliminated. Now if you analyze this state table, A, next state of A, DC, B, DC, C, DA, D, DC, and also output also listed. So if you analyze this state table, A, next state of A, DC, B, DC, same time output also 0. So it clearly indicates A, B, states A, B are having same next state and same output. So now AB can be called as redundant state. If you find any redundant state, one state can be eliminated. So accordingly, we can eliminate B. So when you remove B, wherever you have B in state table, that should be replaced by A. This is called state reduction method. It must be done when designing any synchronous sequential circuit. It is compulsory process. Next, we will discuss about state assignment. A very important information, sometimes present state will be represented by alphabetic character. So after developing state table from the state diagram, to proceed further, that state alphabetic character must be replaced by binary number. Suppose you have 4 present state A, B, C, D, then that can be replaced by 2-bit binary number. Suppose you have more than 4 state, less than 8 state, then that can be replaced by 3-bit binary number. Suppose you have more than 8 state, that can be replaced by 4-bit binary number. This is the procedure to be followed to assign binary number. Suppose we have 5 present state. Sometimes in the given state diagram, 5 present state will be there. So at the time, you have to assign 3-bit binary number. But we have 8 3-bit binary number from 0 to 7. Already we have 8 3-bit binary number. Out of 8 number, you have to assign only 5 number. There is no another way. You can choose random value. No issue, you can design the circuit. But finally, if you analyze, more number of logic gates will be there, I'm sure. If you assign random value, more number of logic gates will be there. To avoid, we can go for state assignment technique. State assignment means states having the same next state for a given input should be grouped into logically adjacent cell in K-map. This is definition of state assignment. Then you have to apply this state assignment procedure when assigning binary value. Now I am going to explain the next slide. This is the state diagram. Then from the state diagram, I have developed a state table. After developing state table, when we analyze, we have identified B and E are having same next state. Don't consider output. No need to consider output. B and E are having same next state. So now A can be assigned 0, 0, 0. No issue. Random value given to the A. So after assigning A 0, 0, 0 in corresponding cell, in nearby I have given three variable K-map. In three variable K-map, the cell related with 0, 0, 0, A can be entered. So entered A value. Next, you can assign 0, 0, 1 to the B, no issue. So cell related to 0, 0, 1 must be entered B, okay, no issue. But very, very important information, already we have identified B and E are having same next state. So E must be assigned adjacent to the B. Wherever you can assign B, then nearby cell should be allotted to E. This is called state assignment. So accordingly, E value 0, 1, 1. You cannot choose random value to E. E value can be chosen based on B. This is called state assignment. So after applying state assignment, if you design synchronous circuit, finally number of gates will be reduced. This is the advantages of state assignment technique. Now I am going to design a circuit. Here state diagram has been given. They have given condition to use JK flip-flop to design this circuit. So state diagram is given. From the state diagram, we have identified 4 present states are there: 00, 01, 10, 11. Then I have developed state table: 00, 01, 10, 11 present state. The next state can be identified from state diagram. For example, 0, arrow starts and ends at same circle. So present state, next state same. So in now you can analyze next state x equal to 0, 0, 0. When x equal to 1, arrow moves to 0, 1. So 0, 1 has been assigned. Now analyze state table. Next conditions 0, 1. Now consider present state 0, 1. 0, 1, 0 means it goes to 1, 0. So x equal to 0, 1, 0. X equal to 1, 0, 1. Similarly, you can develop state table by using state diagram. Then after developing state diagram, now you have to develop the state table. This is third procedure. You have to develop the state table. Present state, next state can be copied from previous table. There is no any tough job. You can copy present state and next state from previous table. Then input can also be copied. Then by comparing present state and next state, you can assign flip-flop input value from the excitation table of JK flip-flop. For example, first case 00, present state 0, next state 0, 00. Then now consider only Q0. Q0 of present state, Q0 of next state 00. So 0 don't care. That value 0 don't care we have collected from excitation table of JK flip-flop. Now consider Q1 of present state, Q1 of next state. So 00, again 00. So 0 don't care. Next, similarly, second row 0, 0. Q0 value 0, 0, 0 don't care. But Q1 value 0, 1. So 1 don't care. Similarly, you can assign flip-flop input by comparing present state and next state. After assigning flip-flop input, then we can go for K-map. Here, three variable K-map. In the case of synchronous circuit design, input variables are present state and input. Present state two variable, input single variable, totally three variable. So we have considered three variable K-map for J0, K0, J1, K1. J0 means consider J0 as an output. So J0, only J0 value must be entered in K-map. After entering grouping, then you will be obtaining expression. After grouping, you will be getting expression from K-map. After developing expression, then you can go for logic circuit. Here, logic circuit, I have used two number of JK flip-flop, then simultaneous clock pulse is applied, and also very important information, flip-flop input must be given as per K-map expression. That's all. Based on K-map expression, you have to assign flip-flop input. Then finally, logic circuit has been developed for synchronous circuit. Now I hope you have understood synchronous circuit. Now the same, by considering same state diagram, you can develop logic circuit by using SR flip-flop, T flip-flop, D flip-flop. Thank you.